Here are the most interesting and essential facts about the sea pig. Number 12. Sea cucumber cousins. Sea pigs are members of the sea cucumber family. That means they have their similarities and their differences, mostly in their method of defense, physiology, and habitat. You can also think of them as cousins to the sea cucumbers. In reality, sea cucumbers are mostly crawling segments of intestines, and apparently they look rather delicious to a lot of sea creatures. Now, that means that the life of a sea cucumber can be rather unfortunate. Some sea cucumbers have fish that swim up their butts in order to hide from predators, while others have to fight off predators in the open sea. Does that sound fun to anyone? Their main tactic of defense is to fire their intestines and other organs out of their rear ends in the hopes of shocking their attackers. But it seems that sea pigs are living the good life, a life where they don't have to defend themselves. The sea pigs have a half dozen species in the genus Scotoplanes actually kind of resemble pigs. Compared to their shallow water sea cucumber cousins, sea pigs don't have nearly as many predators, meaning no organs shooting out of their butts. Number 11. Oval bodies. The average sea pig has an oval body with a length ranging from 2 to 4 inches. They're a bit chubby and squishy, but in a good way. One study found that their size actually varies by their numbers and that smaller sea pigs travel in large groups. Sea pigs have a giant mouth surrounded with feeding tentacles, which help them push in food. These tentacles simultaneously face against the current to get a whiff of any food upstream. They have several squatty little legs, and depending on the species, they have 5 to 7 pairs of feet that are used exclusively for walking on the seafloor. Some sea pigs have particularly enlarged tube feet that have taken on a leg-like appearance, using water cavities within the skin to inflate and deflate their limbs. On top of their heads, sea pigs have 3 or 4 pairs of antennae. Well, even though they look like antennae, the structures on the top of the sea pig's head are actually feet, which we'll get to a bit later. Currently, there are 5 discovered sea pig species, but who knows what else the abyss of the ocean is hiding. Number 10. Deep sea homes. Sea pigs live at the bottom of the ocean, specifically on the abyssal plain in the Atlantic, the Pacific, and the Indian Oceans. Most of the time, sea pigs are found living in depths that go as far as 3.7 miles deep. Some related species can be found in the Antarctic, but since the water is colder there, they don't live as deep. Many people have wondered on the internet whether they can keep a sea pig as a pet. The answer is a big no. As we mentioned just a few seconds ago, these animals live in deep waters. The temperature and pressure can't be replicated in a domesticated environment, and trying to do so would be quite expensive. Can you imagine what type of tank you would need? Besides, even if you could somehow replicate these living conditions, finding sea pigs usually involves a small army of ships, submarines, and scientists, which is why the only people who have ever seen them in real life are usually marine biologists and oceanographers. Number 9. Yummy? Remember what was setting sea pigs apart from other sea cucumbers? Yeah, it's the fact that they don't blow their guts out of their butts and when they're harassed by some predator, and that's probably because they don't tend to get harassed too much. Compared to something such as a reef, where all manner of predators can make life miserable for sea cucumbers, the deep sea is relatively safe. However, another reason that they aren't bothered as much seems to be the fact that they're unappetizing to most predators. Their skin contains toxic chemicals known as holothurin, which apparently makes them unattractive to anything that tries to eat them. In fact, holothurin is so nasty that people in the Indo-Pacific have been said to poison pools and coral reefs with this stuff to just knock out fish for easy picking. Number 8. Diet. Sea pigs are deposit feeders, meaning that they eat bits of decaying plant and animal material found in deep sea mud. Remember, their mouths are surrounded by a ring of feeding tentacles that they use to sift through the mud and grab onto food. Each tentacle has smaller structures that function like fingers. Sea pigs are especially fond of fresh food that has recently fallen from the ocean's surface. Most of them will only eat food that has fallen to the bottom in the last 100 days. Yes, apparently, this is what very fresh means when it comes to the ocean's floor. The real feast, though, happens when a whale carcass lands on the seafloor. As it rots into the sediment, hordes of sea pigs will scoot around it, gathering up the nutritious mud. When they're not feasting on the occasional whale, sea pigs are going after all kinds of microbes on the seafloor. This is just as well because such microbes are consuming a whole lot of oxygen in the deep. When the sea pigs pass this microbial mud through their digestive system, they absorb all the good nutrients but also end up adding oxygen back into the muck. Number 7. Sticking together. Sea pigs travel in herds. Herds of sea pigs have been observed traveling together, combing the ocean floor with their little face tentacles. It hasn't been determined whether they actually like each other's company or if they all ended up together just because there are so many of them down there. Chances are they're probably not very friendly as it is. Most scientists agree that sea pigs tend to gather where food resources are abundant. Hundreds of sea pigs will be attracted to that whale carcass we talked about earlier on, the seafloor, and gather at that spot to feast, not because they enjoy each other's company. To be honest, how would they even know they were hanging out with a bunch of other sea pigs? It's so dark at the bottom of the sea. Number 6. No swimming? You'd expect them to swim if they live in the ocean, right? Well, it turns out that they get around by walking on the seafloor. Their 5 to 7 pairs of enlarged tube feet are hydraulically operated limbs that can be inflated and deflated for mobility. And the things on their head? Remember, they look like antennas, but they're actually feet? These upper legs are modified tube feet like the animal's walking legs. They help propel the sea pig along the ocean. And they also serve as a sensory function, helping sea pigs detect the chemical trail of a tasty meal. Number 5. Parasites. So, what's weirder than sea pigs? Sea pig snail parasites. As if living in the bottom of the sea isn't bad enough, many sea pigs have parasites attached to them. There are deep ocean snails and worms that attach themselves to sea pigs and eat up their yummy internal juices. These parasites burrow into the sea pig's flesh because they're apparently extremely squishy, and entry isn't a challenge. Not only that, but certain types of crustaceans actually get inside of them and eat their internal organs. Yeah. That's definitely not a good thing for anyone. Luckily for the sea pig, they don't have a brain, meaning they probably don't pay any mind to what's happening to them. Number 4. King Crab Protector. Of course, sea pigs aren't the only ones living at the bottom of the ocean. Baby king crabs reside there as well, and those baby crabs are an easy meal for predators. As a result, they need protectors. As crazy as this sounds, baby king crabs often find their protectors being the sea pig. In 2011, researchers noticed baby king crabs clinging to quite a few sea pigs as a savvy survival strategy. All in all, the researchers examined about 2,600 sea pigs and found that almost one quarter of them carried crabs. All of the crabs were juveniles of a species of king crab called Neolithodes demodei. The researchers were surprised to discover that almost 100% of the baby crabs they saw in deep, muddy bottom areas were clinging to sea pigs. It doesn't happen everywhere, though. Baby crabs use sea pigs to hide only in places where sea pigs are the largest structure available as a shelter. Hey, who says baby king crabs aren't smart at a young age? Number 3. Reproduction. For all science knows about the sea pigs, there's still plenty to be learned. Besides, they were only discovered fairly recently, as in the late 19th century. How they mate or how long they live is still a mystery. They might live for 10 years or they might live for 100 years. Who knows? Also, they're fragile. Water-filled body often turns into a liquid-like material which makes them difficult to study. They leave tracks, which is a nice little clue, however, in some parts of the world's oceans. The rate of sedimentation is so slow that the tracks that a scientist may be looking at could be as old as 100 years old, even if they look rather fresh. Number 2. Breathing. When it comes to breathing oxygen, sea pigs again stand out from the rest of sea life. Remember those shallow water species of sea cucumber that a fish climb into their rear ends? Well, sea cucumbers breathe through their butts using a so-called respiratory tree. The parasitic fish enters sea cucumbers and they get a nice home and a constant supply of everything they need. Even if such fish lived in the depths of where sea pigs lived, the sea pigs wouldn't have to worry about them. They are missing the respiratory tree their sea cucumber cousins have. Instead, sea pigs breathe through their exceedingly thin skin, exchanging oxygen with the surrounding water through their body wall. Number 1. Population numbers. So, how many sea cucumbers are there in the world? Are they all over the place, or are they possibly endangered? Well, it's actually a bit of a mystery, as you'd expect. Even though their conservation status has yet to be officially evaluated, they're not believed to be threatened because of their global distribution and their seemingly abundant numbers. Sea pigs reproduce freely and form the majority of the deep sea marine population. They're often found in groups of 300 to 600 members, sometimes more. Trawling, the practice of catching fish in a net, is the main threat to sea pigs and really deep sea life in general. However, if we had to guess, sea pigs are going to be around for a long time, probably a lot longer than us. Here's what's next.
Which was likely an African rock python, was pregnant, and was about to give birth to dozens of eggs. The eggs are actually considered a delicacy, so it was kind of a good score for the villagers. While the villagers misread this particular situation, make no mistake, a full-grown python could kill a calf. As Africa's largest...